Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft on the Kid Sheep. Bah-ha-ha-ha-ha. So today we're gonna do a couple things. Shut up, sheep. So we've been working on sort of fleshing out spawn. As you can see, my house looks beautiful now. Shut up, sheep. We're trying to get some farms going. So spawn is more self-sustainable and looks a little bit better. One of the things we didn't have is a sheep farm. So I've kind of been working on something. It's certainly not a pretty, well, I don't want to say it's not pretty. It's kind of pretty, but it's, you know, it's not a detailed build necessarily. It's just a giant cylinder up into the sky with lots of floors and lots of sheep. And this is kind of a clunky design too, and I'm sure this is really loud. Actually, let's turn this down while we do this. Good sheep. Okay. So as you can see, it's just a bunch of floors with sheep of every color. Well, not every color just yet. Still working on that. Right now I'm running short on dirt, of all things. And so we have, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 floors left. I don't know what I'll do on the top, maybe like a dome sort of thing. Seems reasonable with this type of building. Or maybe some sort of like observation deck, because you can see, I don't know if my... this will go up any further without spazzing out with Optifine on. Load. Please. Anytime now. Well, while that loads, that's all this sheep farm is going to be. We're going to have 25 sheep of each color, which should provide quite a bit of wool. It's obviously not automatic or anything high tech, but it's everything you need in one space. This is really, well, what did I leave it on? 16? Yeah, we'll put it back on. What's normal? 15 is normal. Leave it on 15. And one of the things we're going to work on today is a very simple like storage room type thing, so that, you know, when someone's in spawn or when someone's over here at the sheep farm, they can just run through and shear everything and then take what they need and dump the rest in the storage room, so people can, if they need a little bit for a little project, they can drop in here and just get whatever they need and be on their way without having to spend hours harvesting sheep. So let's do it. Alright, so the storage room for the wool is going to be down in this area directly under the sheep farm. Very simple, just a linear storage room, bunch of chests for each color wool. This is what each little module is going to look like, sort of. I might change up this bit here maybe if I think of something different. Let's put one of these together real quick. I hear a zombie. I'd really rather not. So behind here, we got some planks. Need to go like this. Add a splash of color behind the chests. Here and here will be some glowstone for some light, and just for a transparent block above the chest to open it. We need some chests. Already got 4. We need to make a couple more up here. Hello, zombie. Are you gonna give me any trouble? You found somebody else to play with. That's enough, right? 2 chests, 4 chests. Not what I wanted. I don't like doing this out in the night. Bad things. Okay. One chest, two chest. Hooray, we did it. Up, up, there we go. Down here, stick these guys in here, and we need what, 8 wool? So let's go up to the next floor. Need 8. And I'll just go ahead and harvest a bunch and stick whatever extra we have in the chests. You're not getting out, buddy. He's planning his escape. Give me your wool. Thank you. And that's enough for now. And you. Okay. Get out of the doorway. You're not leaving. Bye bye. Ha 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 ha. Alright, so we just drop down here. Toss this in like this, nice and pretty. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of texture to the roof since we really don't have any sort of detail involved in this build. So just adding a little bit of depth up here with these slabs like this, and then this side will be whatever color this is. What am I missing? These. Thank you. I'm gonna run this all the way across. I like a so. So that's sort of what it's gonna look like. Why can't I pick this up? I'm full. Except it'll be much more colorful when it's not just these two colors in here. So let me go ahead and hammer this out real quick. We'll take a final look at it and then go check out a much more exciting project for me anyways. So be right back. All right, time for the grand reveal. I know. Very plain, very simple, but this is just a quick and dirty build for the community. And I think once I get those last 4 or 5 floors done, this is going to be fairly industrious and productive. So, and I might change this out to clear glass. The point was to be able to see up to the top, but this, the white glass is a little bit more opaque than it probably needs to be. But yeah, this is just a simple build. Look pretty, do its job, easy peasy. So, I've been working on something. I guess to be more accurate, I haven't been working on anything. I was working a lot on my base and a couple other projects, and I had kind of hoped that this season doing multiple projects would keep me fresh and keep me inspired, but I'm getting burned out really easily when I go back to these projects, so I need more stuff. But I don't necessarily want to be responsible for... I think the biggest issue is me coming up with the projects to do, not necessarily building them when I get to that point. But hey, who's talking? Oh, right. I forget what his name is. What did I name him? It was like dummy or stupid or stupid. That's funny. Shut up. But I think it would be cool if I provided a service for other people that wanted or needed something built, because then that prevents me from having to come up with an idea from scratch as well as come up with how I'm going to build it. So this is BK and Sons Building Company. So I'm going to try and put together like a contractor type service, and I might try and enlist the help of a couple other people. Because that's how contractors work. They have guys that do specialized jobs. Like they have electricians, they have plumbers. So I might try and get some well, not some, it'll probably be a small group, but like a someone who's good at redstone, because I can't do that. Or someone to do like pixel art, someone to do like interior decorating, that kind of thing. And people can come to us and submit projects, and then we'll get together as a group and go out there and do that. And I think that'll be really cool. I enjoy building this game, but my brain is not interested in coming up with stuff to build right now. So that'll be easier on me. I'll get to do what I like to do. And I think it would be fun to work together as a group with several other people on individual projects. And it'll give people that aren't necessarily builders, you know, there's lots of different aspects to this game you can be good at and excel at, and it might not be building. So you can come to us, hire us, and we'll build you the building of your dreams. I need to enchant a new bow. And yeehaw, party done. Or party's not done, party started. So can you not? What I'm going for with this project is I looked up online for pictures of like a lumber yard, because that's the kind of, do I have any dirt? Kind of look I'm going for here. And one of my biggest strengths as far as building goes is taking something like a real world picture and putting it into this game. So I'm gonna try and post it up. Can you not? I'm busy. If I remember, I'm gonna stick the picture up in the corner right about now. Look at that, I did it. If you look at it, I think it's like a, it's definitely a toy. It might be from like a train set or something. But it had that look I was looking for, like a wood storage area. So you can see I got all the support beams. And how this is gonna work, or how it would have actually worked, is they would store the logs ac laying across all these beams. It was usually one, actually multiple stories. So we have a platform up here. I'm gonna try and rig up some sort of ladder, like there is in the picture, but it's hanging in the picture, so I'm gonna have to come up with something else. But I'm going to enclose the sides and try to do the same sort of shaped roof. You can see I've done the beams accordingly. Hello, butt face, where it kind of slants down more sharply at the front. Back, please. Back, please. And more gradually on the back. So what I'm gonna do right now that we've seen sort of the skeleton of it, is I'm gonna close in the sides. And then maybe we'll try and come up with something like a shape for the roof. All right, so I realized I was getting a little bit ahead of myself on the roof, so I wanted to take a step back and check out the exterior of the sides and the back. So I did, we'll call this the foundation layer. I did that all the way around. Actually, this is a technique I saw in, shoot. Somebody. I think it's his name is Kingy. I forget what server he's on, but he was doing like a decorating video on one of his single player videos, and some guy that was playing with him showed this kind of technique. It's more effective in the vanilla texture pack, but it's I've used this combination a lot before, but it's the combination of like this. That actually, this back over here is probably the best example. You got the cobblestone, which looks the most deteriorated. Then you got the cracked stone brick, and then the regular stone brick. So it looks like it's kind of disintegrating out from a point, right? Which I think is a little bit more realistic. So I went with that because I think the majority of people are going to be playing with the vanilla texture pack. It doesn't look as super great in the texture pack I use, but it still looks pretty good, I think. So win-win for everybody. And as far as the walls go, I started out with just plain spruce blocks in between the oak logs. And it looked okay, but it looked too pristine, too smooth, not enough detail. So I threw some stairs in here, threw up some trap doors, and I like it a lot better, especially from this angle. I like this wall. I think that looks really cool. So now we have to try and flesh out the roof. And it's not perfect, but I'm okay with that. So we're gonna run this kind of shape all the way down the front side and this all the way down the back, and we're probably gonna build this up another block or something, because that's how it is in the original picture. And I like it. So I'm gonna do it. But let me throw the roof in, and then we'll just do some like decorative stuff as far as loading it up with logs. And we might not do this today, but I wanted to show this off because I think it's a really cool idea, and I'm looking forward to working with some other people on some projects. So let me get this roof in, and we'll throw some logs down in here. Check it out! I got a roof on. It's looking pretty sweet, right? We got, let's see, what's the button? There we go. We got these ridges coming down that add a little bit of texture to the roof. It is a little bit monochromatic, but that's okay. You won't see it from this angle most of the time. I think it looks a little bit better in a smaller quantity, like from this angle where you're getting more of the oak bark. So it's looking pretty good. I went over to Bug's wood shop and spawn and bought a stack of each type of wood. So I thought we'd just kind of stick some logs in here and see what they look like. Where's this going to go to? Right there. So that'll get us started. I'm going to try and do my best to make these. Actually, if I want to keep them like uneven looking, but I also don't want them looking like stupidly long. Like if they don't make sense to be that long, then I don't want them to be that long. Like the acacia trees aren't necessarily tall enough to span this entire span. But a jungle tree or maybe a spruce tree, we could have some logs that went all the way across, if that makes any sense at all. And how many bays do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So not enough for each type, but we do have 2 levels. So that's fine. And actually, I think I'm gonna mix them up a little bit because I could just load them up per, like, have a separate area for each log type, but then I think they're gonna look too like smushed together. This is really hard to work in when I can't get over these fences. Let's just see what it looks like this. That's okay. Glass for the farm. Using the glass from the chest near the portal or the hub. Just diet white. Then maybe we'll have another one. Starts like right here. Sits on top. Maybe comes back to here. What's it look like? It looks pretty good from the front. I like that. From the side, it looks a little bit weird. Well, maybe not weird, but not necessarily the desired effect. But this is all just aesthetic, so you'll mostly see it from this angle, so I'm happy with that. Happy. Let's hop up here. This is slabs, right? So it doesn't need to be lit necessarily, but I will stick some torches maybe up here, the backs of these, just so the room is lit up. And uno más. Love it. Alright, I'm not going to do all of this on camera because it's super tedious. The roof was stupid tedious. That was not enjoyable for me. But it's done, so whatevs. Let's do some long ones. Dang it. You know what, I'm going to take these out while I'm working up here. Just so I can move, and I'll put them back when I'm done. I promise. So let's get one long one that spans the entire thing, like that. Maybe even, yeah. Let's go crazy. Let's get this dirt out. And then we'll do another one, kind of a shorter one along the side here. I don't like that. Let's go back one. Yeah, like that. And then we'll do another one that comes up a little bit further onto the first. Dang, crapper. First support. Can't reach. Like that. Okay. And give me up on here, por favor. Something like that. Let's see what that looks like. Get out of here, and gotta put these back wherever they went. This one there. One there. And one there. Let's check it out. I'll leave that there momentarily. Out. Shut up your face. Let's get up a little bit. Oops. Yeah, that's gonna look nice when it's completely full all the way across. It'll help break up that the color there. And I seem to have attracted some friends. Do I have any arrows? I don't have any arrows. Well, you know what that means? Time to end the episode. I'm just going to use this same kind of principle to fill up each of these little bays. And might do this next time, but it's just going to be a simple little room. Probably the same... same idea as the sides, just on a smaller scale. And maybe I'll do like a colored roof, maybe some red clay or something, just to add a little bit of splash of color to it. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this episode. I'm getting ready to go help P work on the sheep farm over there, so that's it. Hope you enjoyed. This is Burrito King. Oh, don't you walk off into that sea of death. They might have forgotten about me. But that's fine. This is Burrito King, signing off from the KingKraft server. Until next time. Bye. Bye.